Now comes the nida from Allah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. It comes with ya. Sometimes the nida comes without ya in the Quran. Yusufu a'rid an hadha. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. It's for attention here. For more attention. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. O ye who believe. It's to everyone. Every prayer you make upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is written for you. And you get its rewards. Because you are a believer. Gender is irrelevant here. Because it's an act. So amana, male and female, both. We all know that the gender use of masculine in Arabic is not for exclusion of women unless there is a specific proof. But generally speaking, it is a general command. O ye who believe, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. And here it's madi because your iman has already been achieved, is dwelling in your heart, is well established. Sallu alayhi is in the imperative form. Sallu alayhi. فعل أمر مطلق الأمر للوجوب. Originally in the Arabic language, any imperative comes to indicate that it is obligatory. What makes it not obligatory here is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. But still, the ulama say it is obligatory upon every believer to pray upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once in your lifetime. Then there is a difference of opinion whether it is fard or wajib when he is mentioned. And the majority of scholars say it is wajib, it is necessary. Whenever he is mentioned sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, that you make prayers upon him.
يا ابن عبد الله يا ملاذ الخائف الوجل يا ابن